Hello guys, my name is Ella Travis. Welcome back to this channel. And in today's video, I am going to be going over the Joshua Jenkins story. This is the stuff that they make horror movies out of. Not horror. Horror. Anyways, this story does not have a lot of information, so I'm just going to go ahead and get right on with this video. So George and Eileen Jenkins, they adopted their son Joshua in 1980. The family, they lived in Los Angeles, California, and from the age of around 5 years old, Joshua was enrolled in special education classes because he had learning disabilities. He had dyslexia and at some point in his life had been diagnosed with ADHD. His parents moved him around to a bunch of different schools, hoping to find one that would fit him and his needs. It was in 1993 that the family decided to move from LA to Vegas. At the time, Joshua was 12 and his sister, Megan, who had also been adopted, was 7. By all accounts, Joshua loved his sister and he was very protective of her. When Joshua was in the 8th grade, he went to see the school psychologist and she determined that his problems were much more severe than just normal learning disabilities. She noted that Joshua spent much of his spare time alone. He would also exhibit some pretty odd behaviors. For example, he would carry on full conversations with aliens, and he also said that one night while he was watching the TV, needles came out of the TV and went into his arm. The psychologist thought that this might be symptoms of schizophrenia, you know, the hallucinations and everything. George and Eileen, his parents, they decided to go get a second opinion. The other psychologist prescribed him with a medication for ADHD. And looking back and looking into what eventually happened, this medication may or may not have had an adverse effect. As Joshua got older, his mental issues seemed to get worse. He became more volatile and violent. When he was 14, he broke his father's arm with a baseball bat. Both of his parents told people that they were scared of Joshua and scared of what he might be capable of doing. They decided that it would be best for him and his sake to go to the Vista Del Mar boarding school in LA. He started at that boarding school in 1995 and he would stay there until May of 1996. So in May of 1996, George, Eileen, and his little sister Megan, they drove all the way from Vegas to LA to pick up Joshua. They then drove to Eileen's parents' house in Vista, California, and that is where they were planning to stay for the weekend. A few days after this, Joshua was scheduled to have a doctor's appointment, and it's thought that at around 4 p.m. on the day after the family arrived at the Vista home, the fire department was contacted because the house that the family was staying in had mysteriously caught on fire, and it was pretty bad. Firefighters concluded that the fire had started in the master bedroom. Inside that bedroom were 5 dead bodies. They were identified as 50-year-old George Jenkins, 48-year-old Eileen Grossman, 10-year-old Megan Jenkins, and 78-year-old Bill Grossman, along with his wife, Ellen Grossman. They had all died a violent, brutal death before the fire started. And all of the bodies, they were stacked on top of one another to form a pile. The next morning, the murders, they were all over the news. Because of Joshua's mental health history, they figured out pretty quickly that it was probably him. Also, because he was the only family member that was missing from the scene. The newspapers ran a headline about the murders along with a picture of Joshua. They showed the clerk at the gas station near the house a picture of Joshua, and they told him to contact the police if they saw this person. A couple hours later, Joshua, he walks into the gas station and he is arrested a few blocks away from there after trying to evade police. Once in custody, the 15-year-old Joshua Jenkins, he gave a full confession. He said that he found a hammer amongst his grandfather's tools and went to the room where his parents were sleeping. He didn't do anything and he ended up going to the living room. At around midnight, Joshua heard his father heading to the bathroom. It was there that he surprised his father by hitting him 18 times in the head with a hammer. The sounds of the attack woke up Eileen. There was a phone in the kitchen, but Standing between her and the phone was her son Joshua. She tried to make a run for it, but Joshua had jumped on her back and struck her a dozen times in the head with that hammer. It was Ellen Grossman that heard her daughter being attacked, and this made her run out of the bedroom. Joshua catches her and strikes her 14 times in the head. The last one to be killed that night was his grandfather, who was getting out of bed to see what was going on. So none of them were dead when this whole thing happened. They had been hit in the head numerous times, but they were not dead. He didn't kill Megan then, but she did wake up and just kind of asked what was going on, and he said, "Nothing's going on, it's all good, everything's all good, just go back to bed." After she goes back to bed, Joshua takes his parents' and grandparents' bodies into the master bedroom of the house. He stabs them to finish off the job and to make sure they're dead. And after that, he goes and grabs a root beer and sits down to watch TV until Megan woke back up. Joshua told her that her grandmother was very sick and that they all needed to go to the hospital, but Joshua stayed behind to watch her. The two got into the car and Joshua drove to the hardware store where he purchased an axe. They then went to their grandparents' house to watch some more TV. Later that day, Megan fell asleep on the couch, just kind of slumped over, still sitting up, and Joshua just said so casually in his confession that he just picked up the axe, he hit her once with the blunt end, and then he hit her six more times with the other end, and then he proceeded to stab her multiple times after that. Officially, her cause of death was 9 different stab wounds to the heart. He then brought her body to the same room as where the rest of the bodies were, and then that is when he lit them on fire. After the fire started, he drove to a parking lot in Vista where he fell asleep. His plan was to drive all the way back to Vegas to kill himself in his family's garage. But as we are aware of now, he was arrested. He went to trial in May of 1997, a year and a half after the murders. The trial itself lasted about 5 weeks. He pleaded not guilty by reason of insanity, but he was declared sane at the time of the murder. He was tried as an adult. The DA said that Joshua was very emotionally disturbed and he was also a diagnosed psychopath. He also said that Megan's murder was much more disturbing than what Joshua originally told the police. According to him, something much worse happened. There were tiny cuts on her neck, and he said that this would have possibly come from sort of a knife being held to her neck and being strangled or something. Yeah, I don't want to go into it. While investigators were searching Joshua's bedroom, they found what appeared to be inappropriate photos of Megan taken while she was sleeping. And the DA's theory on that is that Joshua had held a knife to Megan's throat because he was trying to sexually assault her. And Joshua's trial, it lasted for 5 weeks, and he was sentenced to 112 years in prison without the possibility of parole. And as of now, his next hearing is in July of 2021, which is this year. And yeah, that was the video. It's a little short, you know, not a lot of information, but I hope you enjoyed it nonetheless. And I am very glad to be uploading twice a week. Listen, okay, I was going to upload last week. I really was, twice. I recorded the second video, I had it edited out, ready to export and everything. Then I realized I did not turn down the background music. So all you could hear was the music and not my voice for 43 minutes. Yeah, it was a 43 minute video when I was done editing it. Please make sure to follow all my social media. The usernames for all of that will be linked down below. That is it, and I will see you guys on Thursday.